Hi all, welcome you all to the lecture video on committees, a part of organization and organizing and staffing module 2. Management and entrepreneurship is the subject. So in the previous lecture videos we were discussing about the different organization structure. We discussed about the line type of organization, line and staff type of organization, staff organization, which is also called as functional organization, metric structure of an organization, and we also discussed about the departmentation, which is nothing but which is made basically on four different types, that is by product, by process, by project and by territory or geography. We understood the advantages and disadvantages of each type of structures, and we also took a case study of Maruti Udyog Limited as well as the Wipro. And we also discussed about the different type of construction projects that are done by the construction company, based on which we discussed about the departmentation with respect to the project. And we also understood how the departmentation could be done with the by the process, and how all the similar kind of machines are grouped up together and in a place, and then that is named with respect to the particular machines. And departmentation by geography or territory, how the sales network of any product is utilizing this kind of departmentation and how it is beneficial. Let's move on to understand what is a committee organization. Typically, committee organization is not a structure, it is not a particular type of organizational structure, but committee is nothing but a group of people who have been formally assigned to do some kind of task or to tackle some kind of problem, and for their decision to find out a decision for the problem or to implement the action to tackle the problem and to bring out the result. In short, we can say or we can define a committee as a group of people pooled up to carry out a definite objective or a defined objective. The group of people may be drawn from various positions, and they may be grouped up together they may be from the same organization or they may be from the different organization who are pooled up together. So we have but they are well aware of the objective for what they have been pooled up together. So the various functions of the committee are, the first and the foremost one is to be aware of the objective, collection of all the relevant information and arrange them in order and in sequence, a thorough examination of the collected information, and the draft of the report along with the recommendations the committee has to give, selection of the personnel and the directing and the controlling them together to achieve the goals. So we can well understand that whenever there is a problem, say for example when the COVID-19 occurred, there were various committees in by the central organization or central government of India as well as the state government of India to carry out all the lockdown procedures and then the unlockdown procedures. Various officials and then the warriors and then the volunteers from health organizations, from the different NGOs, different government officials, Anganwadi, frontline warriors, everybody got pooled up and they have formed a committee, and then the top level committee, middle level committee, and then the one who is going to execute everything through the different kind of people at different set of different set of people at the different levels, and they form the committee. So this is what is a committee is, because objective is known, and then the way that how they have to tackle this, to provide the solution, is also known to the committee. And the selection of the personnel, directing the personnel, and then the controlling them to achieve the goals is already it is formed by the committee. And then the points will be formed by the committee and the report will be made ready by the committee. So what are the characteristics of the committee? The characteristics of the committee is the number of members in a committee or should be maximum. So like maximum it should be from 3 to 6. If the number of people are more in a committee, then there will be the committee may not be as effective as it is expected to be. So there will not be any to avoid the waste of time, and then the to avoid the any kind of conflicts, the number of people in a committee is preferably between 3 and 6. agenda will be prepared well in advance, and it has to be circulated among the members so as to give the time for their thinking, as well as the preparation and analyzation. And once they analyze everything, they will be in a position to advise about the objective and then to make the objective to achieve. So the duties, responsibilities and the authorities are well defined for the committee members, and it should be well defined so that there will not be any kind of conflicts. Committee is always headed by a chairman, and they must be given an complete authority to conduct the meeting. Committee meetings should be in time bound, and it should not go beyond any kind of it should not go for a longer time so as to avoid any kind of dilution. So the types of the committees, what are the different types of the committees that can be formed? Basically, the committees can be broadly classified into advisory committees and then the executive committees. What is an advisory committee? Advisory committee is formed by the staff authority. They have the power to recommend and cannot enforce the implementation of their advice or recommendation. For example, there will be a work committee, sales committee, finance committee, advisory committee to the government of India, like this. So this is formed by the staff authority. Okay, they have the power to recommend, but they cannot enforce the implementation of their advice or the recommendations. Executive committee is the one, the committees are they are connected to the link of authority. That means to say, it can advise and it can also enforce the decisions or advices that are taken. So for example, the board of directors of the company are the executive committees. Work committees and then the sales committees and then the finance committees are the example of advisory committee. So the committees may also be classified as ad hoc committees and the standing committees. What are ad hoc committees? Ad hoc committees are nothing but it is formed on a short duration. Suppose for example, if there is a flood or an emergency that is caused, there will be an ad hoc committee that is formed spontaneously. That means if there is any kind of problem that has occurred all of a sudden, there might be a hurricane, there might be some kind of emergency, that is there the ad hoc committee is formed. That is after this the problem has been given a solution, this committee will be dissolved after the short duration. After the problem is over, after the problem is resolved, this committee is also dissolved. So their members are chosen depending on skills and then experience and the kind of problem that they are going to tackle. The standing committees are the permanent committees. They are formed to deal the kind of problems that are going to be recurrent or the recurring problems or the repeated kind of organizational problems. Example for the standing committee is the finance committee, loan approval committee, HR loan approval committee in a company or in a bank. And there could be an admission committee which is going to be formed in a college. These are the standing committees. What is an educational committee? This is a kind of committee which is formed to educate and to give an insight to the management about the goals of the organization. This also safeguard the company's policies, vision, quality policy and then the regulations of the organization. Advantages of this kind of educational committee is that collective decision will be taken by the members. This is going to improve the kind of decision that is taken and the performance of the organization. It is going to be more beneficial to the company because the collective decision by the eminent people will be given. The valuable decisions will be taken in this by this committee, who are going to be the experts. Committee members are going to integrate all the ideas. The best idea will be selected and then the action plan will be given. And as a member of the committee, manager has to accept the decision given by the expert committee, and the person has to implement the decision. The committee communicates the decision faster, both upward and then the downward, so there will not be any kind of communication gaps. It also gives the opportunity for the committee members for training and development. The decision that is taken, if at all it requires any kind of training, the managers will be given the training and that is suggested by the committee members. And the decisions will be unbiased and it will be action. So there will be the decisions will be definitely unbiased. It will not be in favor of any one person. Decisions will be taken keeping in mind that the organization has to prosper. So what is the disadvantages of forming a committee? Committees waste time because there will be lengthy discussions that may go on and on and on. Probably the committee members may not be able to come to one particular decision. Since it involves different kind of people, different kind of backgrounds, it may not be able to come to a decision faster. So there will be increased administrative expenses. The committee may sit for more than once or more than twice. So the expenses that is incurred in order to give and invite the committee members and then to host the committee, the meetings would be higher. In case of any kind of wrong decision that is taken by a committee, no member will be held responsible. And so because of this, nobody will be accountable for any kind of wrong decision if it is taken. Sometimes the decisions are in the interest of any one department, which is going to hamper the other department process. Sometimes the decision may be taken in it may compromise and then it may dilute the situation. And the committee members may compromise on a particular decision. It is difficult to maintain a secret, maintain the decision as a secret, because there could be many members who are involved and regarding the decisions that are taken by the committee meetings. So if it is not maintained secret, then the secret decision that is taken by any one particular organization may lead to the other competitor who may release their product in advance before this committee releases its decision. So this kind of problems may be the problems that are encountered by the committees. What are the other type of committees we can see? We have discussed about the ad hoc committee, we have discussed about the standing or the permanent committee, we have discussed about the advisory committee, we have discussed about the educational committee. What are the characteristics of the committee? We have discussed about this and we have discussed about the advantages and disadvantages of this. And in the next lecture video, we are going to discuss about the authority and then the responsibility. With this, I complete the lecture video on the committee and hope this would give you a fair idea of why the committee is formed. For example, when we do any kind of technical symposium, committees for the different activities will be formed, core committee will be formed, and then they will be able to take care of the entire operation of the technical symposium or any kind of the conference or any kind of the activity that you are going to conduct. And there will be a success because of the various committees working parallelly together, and then they will you will be able to see the complete success because of the committees. So with this, I complete this lecture video and see you all in the next lecture video on the authority and then the responsibility. Thank you, everyone.